Hello, my lovely people. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, good night. Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Jen. This is the first time that you are seeing me. Thank you so much for stopping by. My return subscriber, from me to you. I love you. Thank you. Did you see this person right here, what this person wrote? During election time, this particular person that is tweeting this thing now, that is losing his mind, that cannot even go to sleep again, because what Ahmed Bola Tinubu is doing to him, he cannot sleep. He cannot walk on the street. He cannot go and visit his mother, because I don't know if he has mother. I don't know. But during election time, he said the Igbos are the fourth. Obi will never be the president of Nigeria. Obi will never be the president of Nigeria. And from nowhere, it's the same person that came out and said, with all the money Obi has, why is Nigerians suffering and he's there and he want to come and be the leader? This is the thing that they're telling this fine man. I'm beginning to think that these people are just angry that they are not as fine as this guy. They don't, that he doesn't have a stinky hand like them. He doesn't have a stinky hand too on like them, because everywhere they go, their stinky hand and their stinky hand are following them. He does not have anything following them. He's not collecting any money from Nigeria. He said even pure water they no give me since I retire as the governor of Anambra State. But they will not let this man be. Is this man the president of Nigeria? Since we are the fourth, Igbo people are the fourth. They have number one, Hausa and Fulani. They have number two, the Yoruba people. Then they said number three is the cow. So number four is the Igbo people. So we have a long way before Igbo people will get there to come and help all the people that are still playing game of Hausa, Igbo, and Yoruba. Then we have a long way to get there, because Hausa has become the president. Hausa, Fulani, Yoruba. He said Igbo. He said, no, it's not Igbo, it's the cow. Before the Igbos will be the president. Obi will never be the president of this country, as long as he's concerned. But now, do you know what he said that is making me come out now to say what I am saying? That he is trying to put me in the toilet where he is, in the pit where they are. And I'm trying to follow him there, but I cannot follow him there. But I'm trying to let you guys know that some of these people in Nigeria, cow is better than them. Cow. You see that cow? So if a Hausa Fulani has become president, the Yoruba has become president. Okay, what happened to the cow? Give the cow now. Give the cow the president to come out before he reaches the Igbo people. We are not complaining. We are not desperate to be the president of Federal Republic Nigeria. Peter Obi told every one of you. But this is the one now, that this man, the same man that said he will be over his dead body for Obi to become the president of Federal Republic of Nigeria. This is the one now that he said, that I just listened to, that made me want to come here now and answer and tell you guys. He said, in Zaria, resident looted bus truck loaded with food items. Residency. That means Nigerians looted the truck in Zaria that is carrying food when people are hungry. He said, number two, at Rimi Market in Kano, resident looted another car full of spaghetti. And government car carrying spaghetti and Nigerians are hungry. And then he said, in Abuja, resident looted NEMA warehouse. NEMA warehouse that have food of Nigeria written on it. And the NEMA warehouse hid it. Nigerians found it and they took it. That's what you guys deserve. He didn't stop there. He said, what effort? When Zaria bus had been looted, Remy Market looted, in Abuja, the bus looted, he said, what effort has Obi made to alleviate the suffering of masses? I almost passed out. Obi is not the president of Nigeria. Ahmed Adekunle Tinubu, that you fought for, you did not ask him, why is Nigerians suffering? You said, What has Obi done to alleviate the pains and sufferings of Nigeria? I feel sorry for you. I feel sorry for you. I pray that you don't have any penny to eat. You yourself too will come out. This is indirectly coming out and saying, Obi, you won the election. Sorry. Instead of you coming out and saying, Obi, you won the election. Please, Obi, we are begging you to please come and help us. Instead of you saying it, you are still inserting problem inside your problem. Don't worry. INEC Select is coming for you. The one thing I like about this INEC Select, at least I like him for something, he's not discriminating. You voted for him, now you go suffer pass. You voted for him, now you go suffer pass. You rigged the election, now you go suffer pass. Even the ones that rigged election, most of them, they buy them during election time. Now them suffer pass. The ones that did not vote for him, they are doing better than every one of you that put your heart and your head and your mind into making sure that Ahmed Bola Tinubu becomes the president of Federal Republic of Nigeria. So he's asking, oh, if all this is this thing is happening, why shouldn't Obi come and use his money? Nah, if not because these people go ask me, say, what is it, Jay? Eh? I'm a male with a lady sin, eh? Quick on here. Quick on here. Mm like this, eh? Mton no ike. Mweli a piajara piajara. Kojara koja kujishi chagaze. Eh? Wele tape, my chaga no no. No nije kuki jack bobi obi your papa. Is obi your father? Is obi your brother? Why can't you guys speak him off your mouth? You don't want him to be the president, but you want him to come and solve Nigerian problem. So when he's solving Nigerian problem, what is Shitty Man and INEC Select doing? So they will sit down and take credit while he's busy solving your problem. Una go same way. Una go suffer. Oh well, we still gotta watch you guys. Guess what? Because the cow has not taken over yet. According to you guys said that the Igbos are number four. That the cow is number three. The same person that is saying that the cow is number three has not called cow to come alleviate the pain of Nigerians. If this step or cow, it's like a cow be a bogo man. It's like a cow be a wogo jump. It's like a cow be a him maga. Are you okay? Are you okay? Why would you leave cow to call Obi? Obi is just watching, looking fine, as fine man that he is. Obi is small, borrowing you guys' sense, but because you guys, the statistics, not the work for you guys. You guys don't know how to put two and two together to make it four. That's why Obi is fine. Obi is still using statistics. Not be only statistics, una go chop now. How una go chop? Una no go use statistics. All they need is just to carry you guys, give you guys a bado and whatever. So this boy that is saying this rubbish, that is calling Obi, get Obi out of your mouth. You know why? Because if Nigerians remember you guys again, eh, they will add you to the prayer that they are praying for INEC Select President and all the people that help him get in there. And it no go better for you. Leave Obi alone. Obi is not owing you guys anything. Obi is a citizen of Nigeria. Even though you guys have used your own hand though, to take him out as a citizen of Nigeria, he's not bothering any of you. You guys have grabbed and run with it. But you don't know how to use what you grabbed and run with it and make good use of it. Leave Obi alone, no. Don't let in the Nigeria to come after you. Don't let them come and ask you questions. Don't let people come and on your channel or whatever and ask you, now what is wrong with you? If you cannot afford rice, tell Obi, knowing Obi how fine he is, if this stupid boy now, if this boy that left this message now come out and said, Obi, I am very, very sorry. Please, I cannot afford a bag of rice. Can you please give me a bag of rice? Knowing Obi, knowing how fine this man is, eh? Even if you're there for Kafanchan, Obi go buy rice. Carry rice, come give you. Just to show you, say, now go to better pass you. go just to show you say monkey kill. So my brothers and my sisters, I saw that, I said, chai, shame. When people do something that is unheard of, they will be so shameful to even talk about it. They will be so shameful when they, some of them said, we went to the market, we went to the church, we went naked for Ahmed Bola Tinubu to become president. Those people have realized that they made a mistake. And they came and they apologized to Obi. I said, Obi, because forgive us because we didn't know what we were doing. But it's only this man that probably cannot afford something to give to the son or to the children, or probably don't have a place to live, probably living under the bridge, that is coming out to say Obi. Because if he was not suffering like other people were suffering, he will not come out and said, if you have all this money, why don't you, all this money you have, why are Nigerians suffering? Like, he is the president. This man won the presidency. And because the cow has not become president yet, you guys took it away. He didn't even give it the cow that you said is number three. At least when you take it away from the fourth person that won it, you give it to number three. No, you didn't give it to number three. Because you know what number three can do to you. You know what number three, all of them with their brothers and their sisters and their kidnappers to come and get you. But he did not go there. But all you remembered was Obi. Why? What effort has he made to alleviate the sufferings of the masses when he's not the president? When Tinubu grabbed and ran with the mandate that was given to him, is it because he's a fine man? Is it because he's one of those people that will not bring war to you guys? Is it because he's one of those people that don't want any problem in our country, that is keeping his people quiet? Unu, keep quiet, because I will not gain anything if you guys go out there. All they are good at is send people to come and delete you guys. Who will I be? What will I do? Whose president will I be if they delete you guys? Keep calm. The day will come, one day, when something will happen to Nigerians, and Nigerians will finally wake up and said, this person is Yoruba, this person is Igbo, this person is Hausa, this person is a cow, this one is a goat. I ain't go buy every one of you. Until you guys wake up and know that if we don't fight together, if we don't stay together, if we don't stay together and grab this thing from the people that are sitting on us, they will continue to go. Their children are not at home. They are, whatever it is, the people are so wicked that they can't even invest the money that they collected from Nigeria in Nigeria. They are so wicked, they will invest it outside. And you call the man that don't even have any investment outside. You call the man that don't even have a home outside. You call the man that live in Nigeria in his village, that don't even have security officer in his village, that can go to Anambra State anytime, go to any state anytime he wants. Tell Ahmed Bola Tinubu to walk out of his house without security. Tell Wike to come out without security. But this man can do it without anybody bothering him. All he's getting is, thank you, sir. Thank you, sir, for who you are. And you have the audacity to come and talk about him. If you want to be anything close to Obi, mind the words that are coming out from your mouth. Because how you talk to him will determine the blessings that you will get. Because this man has so much blessing in his head. Even the Bible told us to say, anything that you guys have blessed here, he's blessed over there. Hey, God. Now, Bible talk. If you are cursed in here where we are, you are cursed over there too. So you go figure who is being blessed here and who is being cursed here. Because both of them, the Bible told us that God is recording every one of them. So I am not scared of what is coming out from all of you. I am not scared and I am not shaking at all. And you can tell that Peter B is not shaking at all. Peter Obi is minding his business, doing what he's doing, what he is supposed to be doing. Why should he come and help your government? Why should he come and help your government? If you grab and run with it, do the work. You want to show that you can grab and run with it. And you want this man to come and help you grab and run with it while you collect credit. That yes, you did this, you did that, you did. It does not work like that. And you destroyed yourself. All of you destroyed Ahmed Bola Tinubu by agreeing for him to be collecting all the Yoruba people around him, all the criminals that have been to jail, all the criminals that have collected Nigerian money. Why don't you ask all those people that he surrounded himself with, that their names are in FCC? Why don't you ask them? Donate all the money that you have stolen from the government back to the government, so the masses that you are talking about can get something to take care of themselves. Why don't you do that? Peter Obi's vice said, oh, when we become the president, we will go to you guys one by one, bumper to bumper. We will collect you. Hey, Agbajamila, you owe us 500 trillion naira. Oh, we have something about 5 million or 5 trillion naira in China. We need you to bring. With command, are you shining your eyes? With command, you need to bring it. Wike, you owe us 500 trillion. We need something for so. We need you to get it. Either they get it or they go to jail. They are not missing words, because they said putting them in jail is not going to give us the money. But we will give them what they would do to bring out all those monies. We'll give them choice. If they don't do what we ask them to do, then that means they are looking for the other way. So my people, this guy that is calling for Obi to use his own money, what have you, where have you been when the masses are suffering? Chineke Popa Nelok, from me to you. Thank you so much for watching.